Five career criminals get their revenge on the police for rounding them up in a lineup together. They pull off a $3 million emerald heist, causing them to garner the attention of an underworld crime figure, one that persuades them to do an incredibly dangerous job.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on the farm he shot some guys. Bada boom, bada bing, bang, boom.
That's the premise of one of Bryan Singer's first movies, the first being Public Access. However, spoilers ahead. If you haven't watched the movie or would like not to have the ending spoiled in a major way, I suggest that you go and watch it now. I think it's currently available on Netflix, actually. In my mind, for first-time viewers, storytellers and writers, this is the epitome of the perfect twist on the tale. And it all came about because Bryan Singer didn't know how to do the big reveal towards the end. It was at nighttime, next to a sleeping bag, that he had his eureka moment. Just like in the movie itself, it's a well-crafted, morbid Conan caper flick, explored through the medium of film. But how? Why is it so good? Because of subtlety? Because of nuance. The tiny little details are there that anybody could miss, especially on a first viewing. It's definitely the kind of film that requires repeat viewing.
This is shit, but hey, I'm in a police station.
Can we get started again?
Now, what happened after the lineup?
And speaking about tiny little details, did you see that one? I bet you missed it, didn't you? Without watching the whole movie, without taking in everything, this moment could pass you on as nothing but a simple look. A look to be dismissed as nothing but a look. Chris MacQuarrie and Bryan Singer in this single shot achieve more in a second than many other movies and stories try to do over the entire story itself. And it's all to do with subtext, with the small clues that the writer and the camera decide to leave us with. But how do we do this for our own stories? One of the simplest ways is to start at the end. Here you could tackle it by the ending being Agent Kuyong finally understands and thinks he knows who Kaiser Soze is. He knows who the ultimate criminal in all of this is, which is Keaton, who he's been vying out for in the beginning. And then you would work backwards. You would try and reverse engineer the film, so to speak. You know, you would be connecting all of the dots of all those little clues and bits of information, connecting them just barely enough for the audience to recognize them, but not fully understand them. Or if they do guess what's coming, you've kind of led them down the wrong rabbit hole. It's all about subverting expectations, understanding all the different story structures, cliches, tropes, aspects of the kind of fiction that you're writing, that you're filming. Even if it's a music video, it doesn't matter. If you understand the conventions and everything that is a part of what makes that kind of story that kind of story, or twist it in enough of a way that the audience recognizes that structure or the character type or the kind of film it is, but are pleasantly surprised because you've done something slightly different with it. It just keeps your audience guessing, it keeps the genre fresh, or at least keeps it fresh enough until that big reveal. The art of storytelling is in the editing room. The art of writing is in the editing too. It's in the rewriting. You just have to make sure you get those ideas out of your head, because ideas are a dime a dozen, you know, from your first toilet break in the morning since you get up in the morning till going to bed at night. There's probably at least 50 ideas that pass through your head if you're lucky, or at least 12 if you're not. But it's actually putting those ideas into action, getting something done with them, developing them so they're not just a vague idea or a single scene in your head. That's how novels start, that's how movies start, that's how a musician's masterpiece starts. And putting things into action, creating them physically and working on them until they're bloody good, that's where the skill is. That's where those perfect twists come from. That's where originality comes from too. After all, if you only have ideas and you don't work on them,
and like that, he's gone.
But I hope you've enjoyed this video and I hope you've learnt something. And if not, I hope you've got another movie to put onto your list that you could watch and definitely enjoy. Let me know how you think it goes. But please like this video if you thought it was helpful, if it was entertaining. I'd love to hear your feedback on this new setup that I'm doing. I just want to get better. I want to improve as much as I can. So I need your help. And please share it if somebody's seen The Usual Suspects, if they're not fully understanding in it and they just want to ask questions. If, you know, just it would be a good movie recommendation. Or you are also thinking about that twist and if it's great or if it's not. Definitely let me know if it's not, because that's where discussion can come in handy. And please consider subscribing. I'm starting to create a schedule of many different videos. I'm doing at least one video a week, trying to put 2 out per week. I'm going to start doing a lot more experimenting, especially when it comes to my setup. Like, you should see this crazy setup that I've got right now. I'm going to take photos and put it on Instagram, so definitely follow me on Instagram and you'll see what I'm doing. Subscribe so you don't miss out on any future content. I hope that you're along for the ride. I'm going to be talking about fiction, storytelling, filmmaking, my new production company that I've just set up with my friend V, and we're called Neo Studios. I'll leave a link in the description below, and I'll see you in the next one.